So dear student, I'm going to start the discussion about that chapter 3 that is given here. So chapter 3, values and data types. Okay, so in this chapter we will understand that about that Java programming language and how to use that and how to write that program and what is that program elements. That you see here, that language, when we communicate with anyone, so medium of communication is that language is that. But when we work with that computer, that Java is that computer programming language. So in Java, when we are going to communicate, so with the computer, communicate with the computer, that we are using that characters similar to that our alphabets, that is our English language. So that alphabet we are using as a character set. So Java character set, that first is that letter, second is that digits, next is that operators, and next is that delimiters. These all are the character sets that we understand. Here is that character set given, that first is that letter, wait here. So first is that letter. Letter means that alphabets, that English alphabets, that is capital A to capital Z, small a to small Z. And digits, that is 0 to 9, that we are using. Operators, that is arithmetic operator, that is all basic operations, so that we are doing addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, okay, remainder. Logical operators, that is AND, NOT, OR, we are using as a logical operator. So relational operator, that in Java we are using less than equals to, greater than equals to, not equals to. Okay, so now next is delimiter, that we different symbols we are using as a delimiter in a Java program. The different purpose of these all symbols, these are delimiters. Now Unicode, so universal code, what is that? Unicode means universal code, universal code. That is used to encode character, encode a character. That means worldwide, whatever language we are using, that each and every language having in a computer language having that code of each character. So that is Unicode is used. So Unicode is of 16 bits code, but Unicode also containing that ASCII code, ASCII, American Standard Code for Information Interchange, that is also included in this Unicode. So Unicode advantages is there, universal coding schemes that we are using worldwide in any languages, that means Japanese, Spanish, German, so whatever language is there, that all the characters of that language is supported by this Unicode. So more efficient code, that we are using standard, international standard organization, that providing that standard to anything, and that electronics media also, electronics code that is generated here. So now we support, we understand that this all Unicode and all the things, that all the characters are always having that unique codes here we are using in a computer, because we know that computer is not understanding our letter A, computer is understanding in binary form. In which form? Binary form. That computer having that one code is 65, this is a ASCII code, and that ASCII code is converted into the binary, then computer manipulates it. Now understand that. So these all the table given that are for a Unicode. So but we will use ASCII code, that will be better for us, because Unicode is that in hexadecimal code, so we are unable to that. Now you see here that American Standard Code for Information Interchange, that is the full form of this one. Okay, and that we will understand here, that each and every digital alphabets having 0 to 9, that you see that ASCII code here given. So 48 is that ASCII code of 0, and that 57 is that ASCII code of 9. So 0 to 9, these all are ASCII code given here. So next ASCII code is that for uppercase alphabets, that capital A to capital Z, that is capital A, ASCII code is 65, and 90 is that ASCII code of Z, capital Z. That if you will remember only one, that capital A, that 65, then you can easily find out that C also, that 65 means 66, 67 will be it. Like this you can go also. That next is that lowercase alphabets, that is small a to small z. That you see small a is having 97 and small z is having 122. Like this ASCII code is used, and many more ASCII codes are there. That means ASCII code is that ASCII code, ASCII values that is given in a computer, that is 0 to 25, 255. That means total 256 characters have in that ASCII codes. But here some ASCII code is that ASCII code of white space is that 32. And that different symbols here given, that is ASCII code. Unicode and ASCII code, some difference given here. That Unicode is generalized from form that of coding schemes in numerous characters, different scripts. That means different scripts also is here available. But in this only specific coding schemes are there, limited characters. That is limited is 0 to 255. That means total 256 characters. So this is of a higher range of that codes, and ASCII code is a limited range of codes. This is the difference between that. Next is that escape sequence. Escape sequence is that non-graphic characters that we are using. So for displaying that output in our own way, that means in which way we want to display, this backslash is escapes the general meaning of another following character, one or more characters. That you see here slash t. So when we are going to say that slash t, t is having that one alphabet, t is an alphabet. But when slash t, that this sequence of two characters, but this slash, that means backslash, escapes general meaning of next alphabet, general meaning of next character. So that's why it is having a special meaning. Slash t means this slash t is known as tab. What is that? Tab. So this is known as new tab character, that means horizontal tab. So we will use most widely that slash n, slash t, slash 0, that is null. That is null is means nothing. 0, not 0, not blank, nothing. Next is that using escape sequence. How to use Java in Java, used in Java programming language, escape sequence. Slash n that we use in. So what is that slash n that you understand that? SUPLN. If we write here the hello, and that slash n we have given, then student, what will be that slash n will put that new line from here, new line. That means output will be of this line will be hello, after that student in new line. That means output will be like this. Understood? So now we understand by another example also. That suppose that next that we write like this, SOPLN system.out.println is this, you will write complete that. So here written holy slash n family slash n school. So here is that given slash n, here is that given slash n. That means here it will be new line. That cursor will go in new line. So here also cursor will go in new line. So this is known as new line character. So output of this one will be holy, then family, then school. Like this in three line, but I have written only one output statement as of here. I hope it's clear to you all. Now we go for that next. So next is that next escape sequence is that given. Next escape sequence is given also here that we understand. So next escape sequence is here that slash t. Slash t is tab space. What is that? Tab space. That means suppose here given SOPLN and we have written here hello students. Hello, and after that slash t given, and then given student. Okay, so output of this one will be hello, after that one tab space, then student. That means whatever tab space we are using in a computer from the keyboard, that is 8 characters space that you given here, so that is known as tab spacing. Okay, that we use from the keyboard as a tab key. So same, it will display the output, and the output will come like this: hello student. Understood, my dear? So backslash, that is for putting that cursor at the backslash, that you see display the message on the screen in such a way that part of it must appear under the double quotes. In this we are using that. So backslash is used, backslash double quote is there. That double quotes will means that if you need to display like that, so here that slash double quotes and written here welcome, then slash, then double quotes, then double quotes, then close. So this double quotes is used to print the double quotes, and this double quotes we are writing that as usual we are using for the message, but this double quote to print, to print this one also, to print. That means output of this one, you see output I am writing here, so output of this one will be with double quotes welcome. That means this double quotes is displaying due to this one, because here escape sequence, that is double quotes is that given. Okay, I hope it's clear to you all. Now next thing is that, so slash n here given, that you see that what is that here, that you see that output is given here, slash n is here, so that means from here cursor line is changed, cursor come to the new line and showing that next output, slash n is here, so cursor is also changing here line, and next line is coming from the new line, so that is printing like this. Next is that this one output, that you see that what will be the output of this one, the first number is that A, after printing that value of A is 4 and that is new line, that means cursor will change here and cursor will come to the new line, that is new line is printing with the value of B, that is 5. Okay, next is slash t, that we see that here also that slash t that is given here as an output, and you see that slash t means tab space will be that here, it is a tab space that is showing with that space, that output of A value is there here given, and B value is there 5 here given, 4 here given, and it is showing that space also. That means output will be like this, so as it is displaying with space. Okay, next is that you see that here also that slash t given, that means one tab space is here. Okay, one tab space is here, and here also that slash t after 14 years, that is also here that given, so that's why output will be displayed like this. Okay, so output is correct is this, that with space it will display the program output. Now that backslash double quotes, that as we have discussed with the welcome, here given welcome to, this is the message as usual we are printing, that is displaying here, but here that double quotes given, so double quotes, this double quotes is displaying for this, and this is here also given for this double quotes, so it is showing that output like this. Okay, so now we understand that how it will display that output that you see. Okay, now token, so we are going to understand that token. So token are of following types, token are of following types: individual program element, that means whatever we are, so whatever we are writing that in a program, that each and every individual elements, that components in a Java statement, that is having some special meaning, that is having some special meaning in the program, that is known as token. That you see here that expression is written, A is equal to B plus C dot, dot dot is not that, this is asterisk 5 semicolon. That you see in this, A is here, A equals to is here, equals to B is here, plus C asterisk this one, and 5, and then semicolon, this is semicolon. That is known as identifier. This is known as assignment operator. This is known as again identifier. This is known as operator, that to perform that addition operation. And this is also that identifier. This is operator, literal and punctuator. These all things are known as token. Individual components here, that is known as token. That means assignment is also token. Assignment operator, operator is this one, plus is also token. And this literal, that 5 is that constant value, this is also literal, that token. And this punctuator is also the token, that we understand. So literal is that. Literal are of three these types: integer literal, real literal, character literal, string literal, and boolean literal, and null literal. That we understand one by one. What is that literal? Integer literal means all the integer value, whatever we are giving, that this is a constant, a fixed value, negative or positive. But one thing is that without decimal point, okay, this one you keep, without decimal point, that is known as integer literal. Next is that real literal with a decimal. The value we are using with a decimal, positive, negative, that is not a matter. But which is, this is known as floating point constant, that is with decimal point. With decimal point. This is real literal. Character literal, enclosed in single quote. Enclosed in single quote. Digit is also, but this three is that in single quote, this is treated as a character. This is not the numeric value for addition, subtraction we can use. This we cannot use. So character is that literal that represents with that single character enclosed within that single quote. Enclosed within that single quote. Next is string literal, that I erase this one, that is covering this one. So string literal means that literal that is enclosed with double quotes. So whatever you are writing, combination of alphabets and numeric value, a special character and alphabets, space also. So inside the double quotes if you have written, that is known as string literal. Okay. Next is that boolean literal. Boolean literal having only two values, that is true or that is false. That is true or false. These two fixed values are there, that is used as a boolean. So not as a string, this is different from the string. When we are writing the true, that like this true, inside the double quotes, this is a string. And when we write only true as a small, this is boolean. Boolean literal. Okay. So we cannot, if we write true, this is wrong. This is not boolean literal. But when we write a small, so this is boolean literal. Okay, this is boolean literal. Okay, it's clear as I think. Yes, now I start that. Next is that here. Null literal. That null literal is that special type, another special type of literal that is used as a slash zero, and that is end of that string also. That is string terminator. What is that name? String terminator. And this is marked as a end of the string. Okay. This is known as null literal. Sometimes we are using null also, and here slash zero also. This is also null. Now we understand that. Next is that identifier. Identifier is actually the name of that memory location. Name of memory location which contains the value. Like that you understand that here, if given that int x is equal to 10. So in computer memory, x will occupy that space, and this will contain the value 10. This 10 is that fixed value that is constant. That is constant or integer literal. You can say integer literal, as just now discussed. Integer literal. But this is known as, this x is identifier. Or you can say this x is variable also, where value may vary. This time 10, I will put here 50. So this time 50, I will put here 30. That means value of x can change. But that x is that identifier, that identify, we identify this memory location where 10 is stored with the value, with the name x. That's why this is known as identifier. Okay. Rules for naming the variable. Variable name must have that number of the characters that may, variable may have that. alphabets will be there, digit will be there, dollar sign and underscore. But before alphabets, nothing will be there. Only alphabets will be at first. And characters are the separate word. We cannot, we use underscore without space. You see here that if somebody written x int, so age of people, that age of people, so we can use here underscore. This is correct. But if somebody will write that int age of people, this is wrong. This is correct. We can use underscore. We can use underscore. Next is that assignment. That means equals to symbol is used to assign the value. That variable will contain the constant value. You see here m is equal to 15. That means 15 is going to m. That means m will have the value 15. Okay. That means this is assigning the value. So we can assign this type of value like this, different value. When character is needed to assign, that single quote will be there. A string is needed to assign, we will use double quotes there. Okay. Next is that initializing a variable. That means, what do you mean about that initialization? That we understand. Initialization means static initialization and dynamic initialization. When initialization is done, that is static initialization and dynamic initialization. In static initialization, when we assign that constant to the defined variable, that means when we are going to assign constant to the defined variable, and here dynamic, where we are getting that output of that some expression in any variable, that means that is known as dynamic initialization. Okay, that we understand that. That dynamic initialization and static initialization, that we understand here. When we are declaring any variable and we are assigning any value, like that 0 is assigned to A. This is 0 is assigned to A. Here is that we can say false is assigned to P. That his value is given here as a fixed value. But in dynamic initialization, what's happening? That you see. If that dynamic initialization is that X, sorry, that result of that, result of this expression will be assigned to the C. Result of this expression will be assigned into the C. That means C is equal to A plus B is written. The value of A is here suppose 5 and value of B is here 7. So 5 plus 7. So 5 plus 7 will be 12, and that 12 will be assigned into the C. So in a computer memory, A is having that 5, B is having that 7, but still C is not having any value. C will get the value after manipulation of this operation. So that means C will have the 12 after this. So dynamically at runtime in the program, after calculation, so C is getting that value. So this is known as dynamic initialization. So here that you see square root of A. So if C A is value is 16, then D value will contain after execution this line. So D will contain 4.0. Okay. So this is known as dynamic initialization. Next is that punctuator. That question mark is used for that different purpose. Dot is used and semicolon is also used for the different purpose. Separators, we use different separators. We use separators to separate the variables or separate the line or the body. So comma is used for separating that variables. When we declare that variable integer type, A, B, C, three variables are declared. That means in a computer memory, A will be also, B will be also, and C will be also, that three different variables. So we are separating with the comma. Okay. So bracket, we are used for the arithmetical operation, or like that we can write A is equal to B plus C, like that, minus 10. So that means this is going to separate that operation, separate that expression. Okay. So curly bracket is also used for that. This one also used for that body of that, body of that statement. This is also for used for array. Now we understand operators, that arithmetic operators, relational operator, logical operator, we are using different purpose, that we will discuss in chapter operator that also. Okay. Keywords, that is reserved words, that is in a system that is used for the special meaning, and some reserved words, that some reserved words in a Java also we use, like that class, public, throw, square root, for. These all are in Java that is having some special meaning of these all words. Okay. So So next is that data type in a program in Java. The data type of two types, primitive and non-primitive. Non-primitive or primitive. Primitive data types are having numeric data type or non-numeric data type. We will discuss this one, that we see that here, that you can understand. Integer type of value if you need to store. So integer data type we will use. Float, point type of value, character and boolean, that true false. And non-primitive we will not use in our in this section in class 9. Primitive data type we will use. Okay, that you understand a primitive data type that is used as a basic data type, that is as a primitive data type that is available here. So like that byte, int, long, okay, float, double, that we are using. Primitive data types means that built-in data types are predefined. Okay, that is used in a Java, and in Java that is defined already and we are using. So int x means x is a variable that will have that to store that integer type of value. So x can and contain only integer type of value, that is known as integer x. So primitive data type, that we understand. Non-numeric data type, integer type and floating type. When we need to store that point type of value, that means like that float we can use also, but it is by default Java using double. So float, like that we write here alien length is equal to 150.75. this is float type. Double also we can use double, so amount is equal to 875.34.7270, like that. That means point type of value double, that means big range of value we need, then we use double. And by default so point type of value is used in Java as a double. Okay, now next is that character. So when we need to use character type, char we use. Char ch is equal to a in single quote, like this. So you see here that is given byte, short, integer, long, that a different size is given here, and we can store the value of which type of this, that we can understand. Float type of value that you see here, that given I have discussed also, that double we can use and float we can use. That is used for a small range, so float we use, and for the wide range double we will use. Okay, so it is noticed that in Java double is that by default that is used in Java. Okay, and if you specify that any float value, that we have to write f. We have to write f after the value, beside that value. And you, that means it is a specific value, this is a float type, because f is written. And here d is written, that means this is a double type value. This is f written, this is float type value. Character that we have discussed, that ASCII value is used also. And here you see that char p n, this is that character that we are using. String that you see p, and we are writing in double quotes whatever that written, that is known as string value. We can store in this. Type conversion, implicit and explicit type conversion. Implicit expression, mixed expression we use to convert our the data value, that we understand by this. That you see here in this, c is equal to a, wait, I just start that to discuss this all, that see here, c is equal to a plus b, that is given, and a is of integer type, b is having of long type, that resultant value of c will be of long. So that was c will be long, here will be small c. So that means different data values when we are using an expression, resultant value will be what, that it will be decided by that hierarchy of the data type that is given here. Okay, so hierarchy means according to the size of the data type, that is hierarchy is used. So byte is that very low, and that low to high, that is given here, low to high, this is hierarchy, low to high, that is given. That means double is having that high memory capacity, memory size is there, and byte is having that very small size, one byte only, one bit, sorry. And double is having 64 bits. So that according to hierarchy, we use the data type that you see here. C is having that of character type, int I, float f, double d. And between this, at first slash will be performed, and between this float and double, resultant value will be of higher, that is double by default. So higher data type will be result of this. Okay, so here between that int and this double, between this double and int, so higher will be that double, and between that character and this double, so double will be there. So in such a way, result we will find. Okay, one more thing I want to explain here, that's 1 by 2 written. So it will give that wrong result. So we have to write 1 by 2, 0.0, 2.0, that we will get correct result. Because 1 is integer type and 2 is integer type. That integer type, this is 1, and 2 is also integer type. When it will perform the result, so result will be 0. Because when 1.0 will divide by 2.0, this is of double type and this is of double type, and that when it will perform, the result will be 0.5. how you understand? When 1 will be, 2 will be divided by 1, here will be 0, then will be here 0.5. We have to divide by 2, so that's why it's coming different. Now you see here that we have to use that. So 2 is dividing in 1, sorry. So 0, that means point will be that, then 0, that 5 will be here. So that means in point we are getting that. But when we are dividing that 2 in 0, that 0, here 0, and that is 1. So in integer portion we will use 0, but in double portion we will use 0.5. Now explicit type conversion is using that type conversion, that is this one. Bracket when we specify, that means result type will be like this. So result type when we need float, that we will put bracket here. That here you see that integer type of value we need as a result. So result we need of integer type. It is that purpose of this one. That means according to that, if we specify forcefully and from that outside, user choice is there, that if you want to change that result type value, that you can specify in bracket data type, and that result will store in that integer value. Here that float, that's why here float x. So in such a way we can do, and this is known as explicit typecasting. You see here that what is that typecasting, and byte to sort, sort to int, int to long, long to float, long to double. That means going in lower to higher. That means this is known as implicit. And higher to lower, this is known as explicit. That you see name is just given, implicit, explicit, automatic, manual, widening, narrowing, upcasting, downcasting, compatible, incompatible, coercion, user defined, type promotion or type demotion. And this bracket is used for typecasting in explicit. Okay, now, so thank you my dear. I hope you liked that video and you got that some knowledge. Subscribe the channel and like also, and share to that all the students in your own group and all that. So subscribe the channel. That thank you.